impact on my knee on the table.
There you go. We're just twitching. Is that what we're doing?
We're doing it live here.
We're doing it live?
No, it's
we're doing it live!
There we go.
Okay, new season, American Dad, TBS. How's this transition from Fox to TBS?
Well, can we say that we're loving the attention? Yeah. Loving it.
And a lot of it has come through Comic-Con, noticing all the posters and all what they're putting behind this new season. We just figured out today. You know, we knew that they were all for it and loved it. It's a great season that we've done already, but we didn't know how much they were happy of the episodes that they've seen until we got here and saw. I'm referring to these giant posters and pins, crass pins, and
it was really kind of awkward because the first three episodes of this season were shown on Fox, and then we make the transition to TBS. So obviously, they want everyone to know that we're moving to TBS.
And it's really great to be in the writers' room for years and have them go, okay, we can't do that. Oh, we want to do that, but it's too crass. And now they're like, well, we can do that because it's TBS, and that's really. As Matt
said. Can we say poop before?
We could say poop. But now, as Matt says, we can say two shits and a douchebag.
Wow. Yeah, right. So getting into that, now you guys are able to push the envelope even more, going from broadcast to cable.
Yeah, there's a little more elbow room for crassness.
I think it's a lot more.
Yeah, all right.
Like I've noticed, we have a whole commercial on TV right now where everybody's naked. Someone said, I didn't realize how much this show takes their pants down.
Is Francine naked?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
There's a thing where you flash something, I don't know.
Oh.
Well, maybe that was a dream I had.
That's disgusting. This is in your own head.
Outside of the added crassness, then, what else can we expect from this new season of American Dad?
Thank you. Let's see. Well, there's an episode where Stan and Francine come to New York, and she gets kidnapped, and, you know, hilarity ensues.
Yeah, and people, like the people that still get it. It always amazes me how many superstars are attracted to doing, you know, because when you do a guest spot on American Dad, it doesn't pay a lot of money. And these giant superstars, they come in and they do three lines. They don't publicize that it's Drew Barrymore or Kathy Bates or whatever, and they just like coming in and
it's
doing
a prestige
that.
Thing.
Yeah, we just saw Kevin Bacon in the green room. Now, Kevin's never done the show, but he's going to now. But we did an episode where Roger dresses up as Kevin Bacon. Man, and it looks like him. Kevin Bacon's avatar on his Twitter, his picture, is Roger as Kevin Bacon.
Oh, that's incredible.
So Matt had to go up to him and be like, what the hell, man? Why do you have that? He's like, I love the show. So he's now going to come on. And I mean, he hasn't done the show yet. But so this year, and more music. You know,
we had Uma Thurman this last year. Yeah. And who else?
I do know Kathy Bates.
Oh yeah, Kathy Bates. Love her.
Do you have any guest spots, if you're willing, can say, do you have any guest spots lined up for this season, or is that still top secret right now?
We don't know. I mean, do you never know?
I don't know, and sometimes I'm really good with the hearing voice. I'll sit home watching with my kids, and I'll be like, that was da-da-da, that was Will Ferrell or something, and I'm just saying this, but, we know, the ones that I just said, like Uma Thurman, I happen to only know because I was at the studio when she was recording from New York over the phone, and it was just kind of really cool to hear how into it she was and what a fan she was. Stephen Fry did a thing this year that I got to listen to, and you never know who's going to be on the show. And now what they're starting to do, and I think this season, I don't have any specifics, they start to write like that star. Like now they'll go right now and they'll write an episode about Kevin Bacon, and Kevin Bacon will play Kevin Bacon, and he'll make fun of himself the entire time. And, it's been that good of a show where people are
either that
to
or
it.
He'll be a mailman.
Or he'll be a mailman and just like, why the hell would they get Kevin Bacon to play mailman? Or play everything else.
There we go. Right.
So are there any actors that you kind of wish kind of join to like kind of beef up like a special guest or even be a side character that isn't like named? Like anyone that, like a special voice actor that you like to just have in the crew?
Oh.
Well,
oh.
You know, the truth is when we record alone. So most of the time, at least in my experience, I'm not there when a lot of the guest actors, you know, are there recording. So, I mean, and then it's just kind of more like being a fan because, you know, you don't work with the person. You just might
Right. I tried this year. I tried to, friends with Russell Crowe for many, many years, and he was really interested in doing an episode. So we sent him a couple. Matt sent him a couple, and he's like, I like this character right here. This is, and it went on for like 4 weeks, and he tried to get the time to set aside in his life, but he was, you know, directing a movie, and he never got it. But now he feels bad that he couldn't do it for his friend, so now we got him. So I would say next year definitely might be a Russell Crowe, but it's getting easier to call people like that and say, American Dad, because they're always saying yes now, because it's a great show.
You know, my stepmom, Valerie Harper, she just did a line on the show, but they were doing like a When Harry Met Sally kind of a thing, and she did that line, you know, I want what she's having, except it was the opposite. Like, yeah. I don't want what she's having.
Right. I know, so. My favorite thing is Patrick Stewart, because to watch Patrick Stewart record, and I've seen him record a couple times, like to hear that accent, which we all love from that, you know, say crass words, like there was one at the scene where he has to, where Bullock has to say, I love dick. He's talking about a man, but he kept repeating it, and that's what I just love about the show is people like Patrick Stewart, or Sir Patrick Stewart, isn't he knighted?
Yes.
He is.
Will sit in a studio and say, I love dick for this show, and that's kind of cool.
Wendy, you've been Francine for a very long time now, quite many years. Has being Francine kept you from pursuing other voice acting opportunities?
Yes. The short answer is yes. I'm a spoiled brat now.
Well, is she like so busy doing Francine, she can't do other voice acting? Are there other opportunities you'd like to do out there?
I could. It's just I'm really comfortable with this pace in my career, so nobody on the exterior is stopping me from doing anything. You know, I mean, we have the right to do other work. He works all the time.
We treat the show. What I love about the show is we treat it like a sitcom. So we do a read through on Wednesdays, and then we record on Friday. And then, so, you know, it's not so much like what Dee Bradley does now. You ask him this question. You know, he does this show, and then he does a thousand other shows. But we don't really do this like a voiceover kind of thing. We treat it like a, you know, we
a sit, television
we read
series.
It, and we see how it's going, and if it's funny, well, then we'll record it Friday. If it's not, it'll be rewritten. And so, I mean, it's a little bit more time than you'd think, I guess, what you were saying, yeah.
So, Wendy, does that mean you don't think you're going to get typecast as a Caucasian woman who gets adopted by an Asian family?
No, why would you even make you ask a question like that?
Yeah, it does something.
It's hilarious.
Throughout the years and the development of your characters, has there ever been a moment in an episode where you said, well, no, this is just too much, this is too far, like, why are we going down this path? Or have you just been gung-ho, let's do everything and push it as far as we can?
I don't think I've ever stop myself from doing anything. No, it's never gone that far that I've been so offended that I was like, I can't say this. You know?
Just one time a joke. And it was, the joke was, whatever Steve, my character, was saying, somebody had gotten really skinny. Was bulimic and losing weight, and my joke was supposed to be, he's doing a reverse Jason Segel, right? So Seth MacFarlane knows Jason Segel, so didn't want that, so I had to go in and re-record it. I was fine, you know, Jason Segel, but Russell Crowe was the next option.
Oh no!
And so I had to go, guys. I'll be honest, I don't know if I can say this.
Can you think
then
of
like,
someone else?
It was Vince. We got with Vince Vaughn. But I was fine with that. But they made me record Russell Crowe just in case it was funnier, because I don't have that much power. And I don't know which one that's going to get, so we'll see.
Well, just pre-apologize now.
Sorry,
you've got
Russell.
All this media around you. Yeah, there you go.
Well, Scott, recently Family Guy did a crossover with The Simpsons, and I know that American Dad's did a lot of stuff with obviously Family Guy and The Cleveland Show. Is there any other cartoon, that you'd like to see crossed over with American Dad?
See, I'd want to go for an old school cartoon, like old Saturday morning stuff that isn't on anymore. That's what I think American Dad should do, because, like, what are the big cartoons now? Simpsons, Family. Have we done an American Dad, Family Guy cross?
There were occasional jokes and
jokes
Simpsons,
and so, yeah,
Guy.
I think
not
I did.
Like a whole dedicated episode to my
See, that, I would love that, because Family Guy is. I was a huge fan of Family Guy long before, obviously, American Dad, and we're on the air because of Family Guy. So, I would love to see those guys
well,
together.
I'm jealous that Marge Simpson was in Playboy. So I want to do the Simpsons.
You were in
and
Playboy.
Be put right up next to her, and yeah. We'll see who's hotter.
But you were in Playboy. Francine and Stan. There was a cartoon I just heard where Francis stands there with like a, look, he's naked. And you're sitting there staring at his crotch, and it says, "I will not pledge allegiance to it," or something like that. It was in it, and approved by TBS. There you go.
Playing off of that question, since you are now on a new network, will that limit the possibilities of a said crossover with other TV shows, or is that still open because it's under the McFarlane family tree?
I would think that it would limit, because I don't know if a network would do that with a show that you're not part of, you know. So what are the other TBS shows? What can we cross over with? I'd like to cross over with like a live action show.
The Big Bang Theory. That's all TBS all the time.
Yeah, but it's still CBS. Right. Yeah, that would be neat to, if American Dad could cross over with like, when I was doing American Dad and ER at the same time, I'm like, we gotta. And we kind of did it because I played a doctor on American Dad and they animated it and it looked goofy like me and it was like the Dr. Morris character from ER.
Yeah.
But it'd be neat to do something. I'd love to play Steve Smith as well, like live action.
You could put Steve on King of the Nerds.
Yeah.
See if he could win that competition. There you go. An animated version of it.
That's absolutely true. Yeah, there you go. Yes, that's a TBS show.
Yeah.
That would be cool.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
That's free. That's free.
You sure you're not coming after me? If I could help. Sign this.
Okay. Having gone from Fox and being almost a forgotten show of the animation domination. Not necessarily a forgotten show, but definitely the least publicized out of all of there, bouncing around from different time slots. Now that you're on TBS and you're getting all this, you know, love, basically, how does that feel? How does the, like, does it validate everything, or?
Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, it makes me want to come out and help and all. It's like, energy begets energy, you know? So they're putting it all out there and we're like, you know, coming out and giving it our all and all that. So, yeah, I mean, it's it does feel great to be acknowledged and to be pushed ahead and, you know, I think we're going to have a whole new life.
I think
life.
It's unbelievable. I really do. It really, finally, especially for the crew of writers and animators and producers that have spent, you know, 8-9 years being under this umbrella of Family Guy, you know, to finally be kind of on our own and having TBS literally pushing us up this amazing ladder of the publicity part of it. It feels great for them.
Do you know what it's like to be the redheaded stepchild?
Yes. Yeah. 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 Not anymore, man. Not anymore, man.
What is it like working with Seth MacFarlane? He's obviously stretched himself really thin nowadays, doing all these movies, all these shows.
Boo hoo.
Yeah, right.
What's it like working with him?
Seth is, like, you meet, when you're in whatever business, you know, anybody's in, there's always like a couple that you meet that's like, oh my God, they're so talented, genius. And in this business, Seth's just it. His humor is unbelievable. And working with him, like if you specifically when you get a chance, if we ever do anymore, to actually record with him,
just in life,
it's just this it's guy that's figured out something goofy that he does very well, and to make money doing it. And he's just so, to watch him do the voices. I remember when I first met Seth, I was that guy that was like, can you do Peter? Can you do Stewie? It's before American Dad. And so he'd do this weird thing. He'd do Peter, he'd be like, hey, what are you doing? And I'd look at him, he goes, oh, okay, wait, this is how you hear it. Like, he can do Peter how we hear it on the TV, how it comes through the microphone and accentuates the tone. He's like, oh, you're... So that when he walks up to people and he does it, he sees a little disappointment in their face. He's like, okay, now I gotta... Because it's unreal. What this
guy can do. Wow. Yeah, I used to watch him during Table Reads.
Yeah, and you've probably seen the things in... Like, he has pages and pages where it's Stewie talking to Brian, who's talking to Peter. And he just goes right back and forth without missing a beat. Like, he never says a Stewie line as Peter. He just...
And the same thing with our show. Like, Stan Smith and Roger doing scenes, and it's seamless. Like, you can't believe that, you know, the difference. in his voice, it's coming out of the same person.
Yeah.
You know?
I did the table read for Ted, too, just to help out. And to watch him do Ted, the character Ted, you could have recorded it and put it in the movie. It was live. A table read, you know? He's about to go and do the movie, but it was so good what he was doing that you should have recorded it, and that could have been Ted's final.
He would come to our table reads and just do it cold. Like, yeah, he'd never read the script. Absolutely
time.
Cold and perfect. Like, yeah. I need to read it the night before. You know?
And he's a great kisser. He's a really, I'm telling you.
I wouldn't know. It was good that way. Yeah.
There's time for one more question.
So,
was it going to be a Seth a good kisser?
Nah. I was going to say, like, since you played Steve for so long, and like a lot of nerds kind of relate with you, and then they see you in person, they go, you're not a kid, like, yeah. You're not a teen.
Right.
What's the most social, like, interaction you had with that? That's like a little awkward.
Well, I have a 13-year-old son, which is Steve's age, is like 14. There's definitely disappointment, you know. And someone comes up, and a lot of people don't know. They're like a kid. Like, we were just doing an autograph signing, and he's like, "You play Steve?" And I could see him like, "Mommy, help me."
You know, I'm glad you focused that question to him and not me. Like,
right?
Does your audience know how old you are? Like, that you're 40 years older than your character.
But I do feel, I love Steve, man. And I've become, he hasn't become more like me. I've become more like him, I would say. He's brought out the nerd in me.
Thank you guys.
Thank you guys.
Yeah, you're awesome, man.
Thank you
Thanks
very
for
much.
Making this so comfortable.
Pleasure
we appreciate it a lot. Really.
Pleasure.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Have a wonderful day. Thank you.
Thanks, buddy.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
man. Hope you don't mind me teasing you. Thank you.
Yeah, come on. Bring it on in. We got to get everybody.